Hello, I'm Simon Whistler. You're watching TopTenzNet, and in the video today, we're looking at the top 10 most incredible technologies that you can't use. Number 10, Damascus Steel. During the Middle Ages, swords made out of a metal known as Damascus Steel were produced in the Middle East by using a raw material known as woots. The Damascus Steel was so strong that it is said it could cut through any other type of sword. By examining the steel, scientists could deduce that it had a high concentration of carbon in its mixture, making it much stronger than regular steel, but at the same time flexible enough not to shatter on impact. Even though people now know the composition of Damascus steel, they don't know the exact process through which the medieval Arabs were able to make it. The exact recipe was lost, due in part to the secrecy with which the blacksmiths were making the alloy, as well as the emergence of gunpowder. Number 9. Vitrum Flexible, flexible glass. The story behind flexible glass is more of a legend than anything else. The tale takes place in ancient Rome. It is said that one day a glassmaker requested an audience at the imperial court in order to present a glass vial to the emperor. The glassmaker took a glass vial and threw it on the ground, but instead of shattering like any other ordinary glass vial should, it bent slightly at the point of impact. With the use of a small hammer, the glassmaker was then able to restore the bottle to its original shape. Seeing this, the emperor, truly amazed, asked the glassmaker if he'd revealed his invention to anyone else. After saying no, Tiberius the emperor had the glassmaker killed and the workshop burned, fearing that this new invention would undermine the value of gold and silver in the imperial treasury and possibly collapse the economy. In 2012, the American glass and ceramics company Corning introduced a new product called Willow Glass, which is very flexible and used in the construction of solar energy collectors. The only difference is that this glass can't be returned to its original state. Number 8. Mithridatium, an antidote to all poisons. An antidote to all poisons, as well as a cure to many ailments, is said to have been developed by King Mithridates VI of Pontus, and then later refined by the personal physician of Emperor Nero of Rome. According to historians, the original formula was lost, but did manage to survive as late as the Renaissance. Some say that among the 36 ingredients found in this universal antidote were opium, small quantities of various poisons and their antidotes, and even chopped vipers. Number 7. Greek Fire. Among all of the technologies on this list, we're glad this particular item has been lost to us. Back in 673 AD, a citizen of the Byzantine Empire came up with a weapon of such great devastation, it's still frightening just to think about it. This is Greek fire, or as its inventors called it, liquid fire. With this weapon, the Byzantines managed to save their empire from being conquered by the Arabs in two attacks on Constantinople. Greek fire was extremely flammable, burning at high temperatures and sticking to any surface it came into contact with. It even continued burning on water, making it ideal for naval warfare. Not wanting it to fall into the wrong hands, the recipe for this Byzantine superweapon was a closely guarded secret. It was handed down from one emperor to another, but during a period of instability, this didn't happen and the formula was lost. Number 6. Incan Stonemasonry. The first mystery here is how the Incans were able to bring a 140-ton stone slab from the quarry to a construction site some 35 kilometers away. The Incas hadn't yet discovered the wheel, and based on the stone's polished surface, it is possible that they simply dragged it there on gravel roads, using at least 2,500 men to do it. The next bit of the mystery is the precise positioning of these stones, as they fit perfectly with one another and without the use of any mortars or adhesives. We're talking about being able to fit a single sheet of paper between any two stones. Located in an earthquake-prone area of the world, it is a true feat of engineering that these walls are still standing centuries after their construction. Number 5. Roman Concrete. Even though the Romans were heavily influenced by the Greeks in their architecture, they were able to take those constructions to a whole new level. While the concrete we use today is made to last about 120 years, the one the Romans were using made their buildings last for millennia. It's been known for a while now that the volcanic sand used in Roman concrete and mortar made their buildings last for this long. Moreover, while Portland cement, the one we use today, needs temperatures of about 1,450 degrees Celsius to be produced, Roman concrete only needed roughly 900 degrees, or even less. The only thing with Roman concrete is that, while we know what it's made out of, we don't know precisely how it's made, even though we know the basic recipe. Number 4. The Iron Pillar of Delhi – the iron that never rusts. There is an iron pillar in Delhi, standing 23 feet 8 inches high and has a diameter of 16 inches. This isn't anything out of the ordinary, but the fact that it's 1,600 years old, out in the open, and not completely rusted is. There are several theories as to why it's still standing. One is based on the material it's made out of, which is 98% wrought iron of pure quality, while the other is based on environmental factors. Number 3. Tesla's free wireless energy. Tesla was the one who discovered alternate current and gained a lot of fame for his victory over Thomas Edison in the well-publicized Battle of the Currents. In 1905, Tesla was ready to put into practice his greatest invention yet by building the 187-foot-tall Wardenclyffe Tower. Atop this tower was a 55-ton dome of conductive metals, which continued down the tower and then 300 feet into the ground itself. His aim was to use both the planet itself and the overhead ionosphere as huge electrical conductors, transporting electricity wirelessly anywhere on the face of the Earth. Not long after construction began, another competing scientist named Marconi executed the world's first transatlantic wireless telegraph signal. Though considerably less ambitious, and despite the fact that Marconi's project borrowed heavily from Tesla, his new device scared Tesla's investors. No further investments would be made into the Wardenclyffe Tower. After Tesla's death, many other scientists tried to recreate his invention, but to no avail. Number 2. Starlite. In the 1980s, an amateur scientist by the name of Maurice Ward came up with an invention that was said to have the ability to revolutionize space travel as we know it. He came up with an indestructible, heat-resistant plastic that could withstand 10,000 degrees Celsius. NASA was ecstatic about all the improvements Starlite could have on spaceship and security designs, but Ward was reluctant to part with the recipe, fearing that some companies would profit from his creation. Maurice never released the exact composition of Starlite. He died in 2011 without parting with his secret formula. Since then, scientists have tried to replicate this amazing material, but have had no luck. Number 1. The Sloot Digital Coding System. In the early 1990s, Sloot came up with a revolutionary data compression technique that claimed to compress a 10-gigabyte movie down to just 8 kilobytes without any loss of quality. A lot of people doubted the possibility of Sloot's invention, but the technology company Philips saw the potential and arranged to sign a deal with him. The day he was due to sign, however, Sloot died of a heart attack. Nevertheless, Philips was still interested and prepared to utilize Sloot's technology after his death, but a key floppy disk that contains the actual coding software had gone missing. After months of searching, Sloot's disk was never found, and his technology forgotten. So I really hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, please do give us a like below, and don't forget to subscribe. Also, if you like this video, check out some of our other videos that are over there on the right, and thank you for watching.